Ciao friends! Did it ever happen to you to try to write some code, like a calculated column or a calculated table, try to build a relationship and hit the circular dependency error? It's an unpleasant situation, because whenever you have a circular dependency, it's very hard to understand exactly from where the problem comes from. Luckily, there are only three possible scenarios where you might find a circular dependency. And in this video, we are going to analyze the three scenarios. I want to keep the video very practical, so I will not go through all the detailed information about why a circular dependency happened. If you are interested in the why, then we have an article at SQLBI that we are linking below in the description of the video, and you can go further and read it. Here, we mainly focus on understanding briefly what a circular dependency error is and the scenario that where you might find it and how to solve that. Let's get started. The first scenario that we are going to analyze requires us to create a calculated column in a table. And this calculated column needs to have calculate inside of the formula. In order to show you the demo, I need a table that is unrelated to the remaining part of the model. So what I did is creating a table that I named best products. Best products contains the best products in my company, and it's a calculated table that, as you see, has no relationship with the remaining part of the model. It's not important to look at the code of best products for now. It's important to look that I created a calculated column in this calculated table that uses calculate. Number of camera products uses calculate to compute the number of products where the product name contains the word camera. There's nothing bad with this code, it works just fine. It's neither the best or the fastest way to compute this expression. It's just a demo to show you the circular dependency. As long as this column works, but what happens if I try to build another column with the very same code? Right now I copied the code of the column, I create a new column, I just paste the code, and I call it camera products number 2. As soon as I hit enter, you see I'm going to hit the problem of circular dependency. Instead of creating the column, I get a circular dependency was detected between best product number of camera products, best product column, and best product number of camera products. One of the problems of circular dependencies is that it's hard to understand where the problem is. Here, the problem is in the dependency list. Indeed, camera products depends on all the columns of the table, and the same for camera products too. So this expression does not depend only on the product name. Because of the presence of calculate, it depends from all the columns in the table. So camera products depends on camera product 2, and camera product 2 in turn depends on camera product. If you want to fix this problem, what you need to do is reduce the dependency list of the column so that it includes only the needed column. And in our case, the needed column is only the key of the table, the product key. So what I'm going to do is make this column depend only on the product key. And I can obtain this goal by using all except best products, all except best products, and I only keep the product key. As a consequence, this column will now depend only on the product key. And if I hit enter, you see that I can compute the column. It's a best practice to use this pattern everywhere, whenever you reference a measure or whenever you use calculate in your code. So both camera products and camera product 2, they both should contain all except. If you use the same code in a table that is the target of a relationship, a dimension in the data model, for example, you will not see the error. And the reason is Power BI has specific optimizations that kick in and reduce automatically the dependency list. This works if you do that in a dimension, but it's the result of an optimization. By changing the code, by making the code more complex, for example, using use relationships or when you work with composite models, this optimization does not kick in. That is why it's always a best practice whenever you use calculate in a calculated column to use all except to reduce the dependency list to only the columns that are actually needed. Now, This was the first the first scenario where you might have a circular dependency in calculated columns. But you might have circular dependency also with calculated tables as soon as you try to build relationships between a table in the model and the calculated table. That dependency does not depend from the calculator. Instead, it depends from the presence of the blank row. Again, we are not going to explain the details. I just want to show you how to solve it. We need to spend some time understanding this code because now it is relevant. This table computes the products that are in the top 5% of Contoso products. So it places a filter for the brand to be Contoso, then computes the value of sales that places a product in the top 5%, and finally it retrieves from all the products the ones where the sales amount is greater than the minimum sales. Out of the product table, I only retrieve the product key and the product name. And the result, as you see, is a table that contains the product key and the product name for only the products which are Contoso and in the top 5%. This table works fine and I have it here. Now look what happens if I try to build a relationship. If I try to build a relationship between a product key and a product key this way, everything works just fine, I can do that. But if I try to build the relationship the other way around, so from product key to product key, I obtain a circular dependency error. It says that a circular dependency was detected, and then the error message is really hard to understand because it uses codes that are nearly impossible to understand at first glance. The problem this time is the dependency of the blank row. If I were able to build the relationship, the product table might contain the blank row or not, depending on the value of best product. And best product in turn depends on product because the way I computed it. So in order to solve this problem, I need to break the dependency on the blank row. And in order to break this dependency, what I need to do is replace any function that references the blank row with another function that does not use the blank row. All references the blank row, or no blank row does not. Distinct does not reference the blank row, values does. So we need to replace all the instances of all with all no blank row and all the instances of values with distinct. And that will be enough to fix the problem. Let's do that. If we look at this code, we have all that is used here, and we can get rid of it and place all no blank row. This would not be enough because if I try to build the relationship again after having replaced all no blank row, you see that it still does not work. If I build the relationship this way, I still have my circular dependency error. There is still an all very well hidden in my code. And even though you look at the code and you will find all nowhere, you need to remember that this filter product brand Contoso is actually expanded by DAX. This becomes filter all product brand, where product brand equals Contoso. You write a simple condition, but actually this is the code that the engine executes. And now you see it all here. We need, instead of using all, to use all no blank row. Now my code does not contain references to the blank row anywhere, and I can build the relationship the right way. I can go ahead, and now the relationship is fine. Actually, I don't want a many, a one to many, a one to one, I want a many to one regular relationship, and that works. As you have seen, we had to replace all with all no blank row in order to make the relationship work. Now, a very similar scenario happens whenever you try to build a relationship not with the calculated table, but based on a calculated column. Also, in this case, you need to replace any reference to all with all no blank row, and you need to worry about the presence of the blank row. Let's see that with a demo. In order to show you that, I created a table that contains price ranges. I want to slice my product by price ranges. So I have a table with only three rows that contains the price range key, the range, the minimum, and the maximum value. Now, this table right now has no relationship with the remaining part of the model. You see that if I place it here, it has no relationship with the product table. What I want to do is build the relationship between product and price ranges. And to do that, I created a price range key column in the product table that is the base of my relationship. What does price range key do? Well, it takes the current product unit price and then searches for the price range key in price ranges where the minimum and maximum values are less than and greater or less or equal and greater than the current price. This column computes a correct number. You can see it here. I have the price range key computed in my product table, and now I want to use this column to build the relationship. Unfortunately, this is not going to work. If I try to build the relationship, I still hit the problem of the circular dependency. Same error as before, and the reason is the very same, but now this problem is in the calculated column. We need to search for references of values and get rid of them, and we have one here. But before doing that, we are using calculate. Now, calculate forces context transition. So let's get rid of context transition first, because we don't want this calculate is useful only to place these two filters. It does not rely on context transition. So we remove the filter from the product, and then we replace any reference to values with distinct. We already know this is not enough because we have two hidden all here. Remember this price range's mean value less than the current price? This is actually filter all price range's mean value. We need to replace this exactly as we did earlier. So this becomes a filter all no blank row of price range's mean value where the mean value is less than the current price. This comma is not needed. And the same way, I need to do a filter all no blank row of price ranges max value where the max value is greater than the current price. If I did everything correctly, now this code is much longer than before, but I get rid of all the dependencies from the blank row. And if I now go here, I can create the relationship between the product table and the price ranges table. That allows me to slice by price range my product table. As you have seen, whenever you have a circular dependency, this has two simple causes. If you are working with calculated columns, the most likely cause is that you are using calculate in your calculated column and the dependency list is much wider than expected. Therefore, what you need to do is use all except to get rid of all the dependencies except the one from the primary key. If you're working with relationship, on the other hand, then the circular dependency comes from the blank row and you need to get rid of dependencies from the blank row by using all no blank row instead of all, value distinct instead of values, and apply remove filters whenever needed. Doing this simple modification lets you work without circular dependencies. Remember, if you want to understand more about the topic and if you want to go really deeper and reach the next level, we have an article at SQL BI that you can read in order to understand all the details. Enjoy DAX!